So, good morning, very good morning. Myself, Yoga Raja, Assistant Professor, Department of Automobile Engineering. So, today we'll discuss about the basics of engineering thermodynamics. So, the thermodynamics, so what is meant by thermodynamics? So, it is defined as the science of energy. And also mainly we are discussing about the energy. So what is mean by energy? That it can be viewed as the ability to cause changes. And so mainly the science of relation between heat, work and properties of the systems. So mainly we are discussing these concepts in the thermodynamics. And thermodynamics, particular word derived from the Greek. So thermo, it is called as heat, and the dynamic is called as power. So simply you can define as the efforts to convert heat into power. So that is thermodynamics. So the basic properties, pressure, volume, and temperature. So the relation between these properties mainly focusing on the thermodynamics. So so we'll discuss about the laws of thermodynamics. So mainly we have three laws of thermodynamics: zeroth law of thermodynamics, first law of thermodynamics, and second law of thermodynamics. So now we'll discuss about zeroth law of thermodynamics. So zeroth law of thermodynamics, so mainly discussing about the temperature, okay, equilibrium of temperature. So we know that what is mean by temperature. It is a measure of whether it may be hotness or coldness. So, and again, we cannot define the particular word exactly based on the physical sensations. So we express the level of temperature qualitatively, so with the different words, freezing, cold, warm, hot, and red hot. But so mainly the zeroth law of thermodynamics, it states that so two bodies are in thermal equilibrium with a third body. They are also in thermal equilibrium with each other. So in the presentation, so we have iron is 150 degree centigrade. So after a few minutes, it may reduce to the 60 degree centigrade. And if you take copper, is 20 degree centigrade. Okay, both iron and copper are contact with each other. So initially iron having the maximum temperature 150 degree centigrade, copper having 20 degree centigrade. So after a few minutes, both iron and copper will be in equivalent temperature. So that is called thermal equilibrium. So two bodies reaching thermal equilibrium. So after being brought into contact in a isolated enclosure. So it means closed enclosure. And so you can see the another diagram is available. So we can take the material A and material B and material C. Material A and material C both are directly conduct each other. And material B and material C can directly conduct each other. But A and B, there is no direct contact. So here the two systems, A and C, B and C, and A and B is not directly contact each other. So initially the temperature of material A having the different temperature, and material C also having the different temperature. After a few minutes, both A and C will be thermal equilibrium with each other. So because of the direct contact, and again coming to the material B and C having the different temperatures initially. After a few minutes, both will be in thermal equilibrium. So here you can say that material A thermally equilibrium with material C, and material B thermally equilibrium with material C. So you can say that mathematically A equal to C, then B equal to C. So therefore material A also equal to material B. So because material A and B, there is no direct contact, even though we have indirect contact is available. So both A and C also equal to B. Okay, so according to this zeroth law of thermodynamics, two bodies are in thermal equilibrium with a third body. So A and C is two bodies are in thermal equilibrium with a third body B. They are also in thermal equilibrium with each other. So that is the zeroth law of thermodynamics, and so mainly it focusing on the temperature. So if you take the temperature scale, we have in SI units and English system, but we are in our SI units, we can take it as Celsius scale. So we can take the temperature having the different units in terms of degree centigrade and Kelvin, and also Rankine and degree Fahrenheit. So the mainly the zeroth law of thermodynamics discussing about the temperature, and again the units also. So we have the Celsius scale, we can take it as ice points and the steam points. So that may be assigned the values are 0 degree centigrade and 100 degree centigrade respectively in the Celsius scale. The same ice point and steam point in the Fahrenheit scale are 32 degree Fahrenheit and 212 degree Fahrenheit. So these are often referred to as the 2-point scales, since temperature values are assigned at two different points. Okay, so that is the difference between the degree centigrade and degree Fahrenheit, and again we can take it as Kelvin also. So the degree centigrade also connected with Kelvin, so directly we can find out. So Kelvin in terms of Kelvin equal to, so the temperature in terms of degree centigrade plus 273.15, so we can add it, so we may get the degree centigrade into Kelvin. So the same procedure in terms of Rankine scale also, so degree Fahrenheit plus 459.67, so we can convert degree centigrade into Rankine scale, and so Rankine scale into Kelvin, that also Rankine scale equal to 1.8 into degree Kelvin. And again, so we can use the separate formula to convert degree centigrade into Fahrenheit. So the degree centigrade equal to degree Fahrenheit minus 32 divided by 1.8. So we can get the different temperature scales. And again, these different scales are used in the temperatures. Okay, degree centigrade, Fahrenheit, Kelvin, and Rankine also. So coming to the first law of thermodynamics. So the first law of thermodynamics also calls us conservation of energy principles. So this simply states that during an interaction, so energy can change from one form to another, but the total amount of energy remains constant. So in the diagram you can see here, as a human being, we are getting 5 units energy as a input, and so 1 unit stored as a energy, and the remaining 4 units energy lost to the surroundings. So you can say that, so that's why the energy balance, that is very very important in the first law of thermodynamics. So energy coming into the system and energy leaving from the system, and energy stored in the system must be equal to the energy stored in the system. Okay, so that is the first law of thermodynamics. So here also the potato that can absorb the heat, so from 5 kilojoule to the inside of the potato, so the increase in the energy of the potato in an oven, so that is equal to the amount of heat transferred to it. So that is the first law of thermodynamics. And again, you can say that the rock is falling from the top of the hill. So initially, the potential energy was 10 units, and again, kinetic energy it was zero. But after that, the rock falling from top to bottom, so the unit conversion also takes place. So potential energy degraded from 10 units to the 7 units to the minimum, and kinetic energy is increasing from 0 to 3 units and become 10 units say kinetic energy when the rock reaches to the bottom, but potential energy will be 0. So here what happened, the energy conversion takes place in this particular rock. The only energy conversion takes place. So we know that as per conservation of energy principle, energy cannot be created nor destroyed, but it can transform one form of energy into another form of energy. So that is the first law of thermodynamics. So thank you for this wonderful lecture. Thank you.